Welcome back to the Feud, everybody. The Abundance family won the game. Woo! And now it's time to play
Fast Money.
All right, you ready?
Ready.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Come on, man, let's go.
Let's go.
Name a part of a man's body that if hair were ripped from it, it might cause him to cry.
Penis.
When you... Okay, I time out.
It would hurt. It would hurt. Yeah. It would hurt.
No, he ain't laughing. I had to stop because I teared up. As soon as he said, I heard all the men gasp from your penis. Okay, here we go. Start with question two. When you trust your gut, what percent of the time are you right?
80.
Name a fear many people have.
Heights.
When you just got fired at work, where do you go?
Pass.
Name something that expires.
Milk.
You just got off work, where do you go?
Friends house.
All right, let's go. Oh. Name a part of a man's body that if hair were ripped from it, keyword ripped, it might cause him to cry.
Or die.
You said your penis heart attack. Survey said. When you trust your gut, what percentage of time are you right? You said 80. Survey said? Name a fear many people have. You said heights. Survey said? You just got fired at work. Where do you go? You said friend's house. Survey said? Name something that expires. You said milk. Survey said. Milk. All right, Priscilla, I got some good news for you. Francisco got a 139 points. You need 61 to win. The 61 is still tough in the second position, so I want you to focus for me, okay, Priscilla?
Yes.
All right, let's remind everyone of Francisco's answers. 25 seconds on the clock, please. Come on, let's go, Priscilla. Name a part of a man's body that if hair were ripped from it, it might cause him to cry.
Penis.
Okay. What am I supposed to do? She said the same thing. It's unbelievable. Okay. Afterwards, you said nipples.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, that's her answer. We don't have to do that no more. Okay, cool. Okay, good answer. Okay, here we go. When you trust your gut, what percent of the time are you right?
80.
Try again.
100.
Name a fear many people have.
Heights.
Try again.
Flying.
You just got fired at work. Where do you go?
The bar.
Name something that expires.
Your license plates.
Thank you. Name a part of a man's body that if hair were ripped from it, it might cause him to cry. You said, that ain't what you said at first. Survey said? Chest was the number one answer, 26 away. When you trust your gut, what percent of the time are you right? You said 100. Survey said 80. 80% was number one. Name a fear many people have. You said flying. Survey said.
Wow.
Fear of heights was number one. You just got fired at work. Where do you go? You said the bar. Survey said. Yeah. Something that inspires food and milk. Food and milk was number one answer. 3-day total, $40,575, and they're coming right back on Family Feud. Oh, this is gonna be a good one. Top 8 answers on the board, ladies. Here we go. There's a dead body in your house. Cops will blame you. What do you do with the body?
Put it in the fridge.
Put it in the fridge. That's a Cleveland answer, folks. That's a Cleveland answer. Put it in the fridge so it don't smell and we'll think of something. Put it in the fridge.
Bury it outside.
Bury it outside. That's a Texas answer. Take it outside and bury it. There's a dead body in your house. Cops gonna blame you. What do you do with it?
Since I am from Texas, I am going to barbecue it. I'm sorry.
No evidence. No. No evidence. No. Good answer, girl.
Oh, we just got a little Jeffrey Dahmer family sitting out here. I'll be damn, barbecue. Barbecue. Yeah. 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 Okay, Miss Vanessa, there's a dead body in your house. What you gonna do with the body?
I'm gonna cut it up.
Yeah!
Gonna cut it up. Big Mac, there's a dead body in your house. What you gonna do with it?
I'ma prop it up in a chair, dress it up, to look like it's not, gonna act like it's sleep. Gonna act like it's sleep, Steve. Gonna act like it's sleep. Gonna act like sleep. That's my answer. Gonna dress it up like sleep. Gonna dress it up like Steve. I'm dressing up like it's sleep. Sitting up in the chair. No?
You gonna set him up in the chair.
Right, right.
Dress him up.
Yeah, act like he...
Set him up and make him just act like he's asleep.
Yeah, just act like he's chilling a little bit. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Oh, chilling. He chilling.
Yeah, chilling a little bit.
He chilling.
Yeah. Yeah?
Woo, okay. Prop him up, make him look like he's chilling. Gerald, you got two strikes. Another family could steal. There's a dead body in your house. What you gonna do with it?
Put him in acid.
Oh.
Ooh. Good answer. Good answer. Yeah.
Wow. Well. Well, that's not funny. Because Gerald say, got some jokes for that, Mr. Funny? I'm gonna put him in acid, burn him up, do him look like a puddle of pee. There's a dead body in your house. Cops will blame you. What do you do with the body?
I think I would put him in the trunk.
Put him in the trunk. Number 8.
Trash,
7.
Tossing away.
six.
Take some
paper. Yeah, take it right over their house. Throw it in their yard and call the police. Four. He's gonna stink. Number three.
Hard cops anyway.
Wait a minute, though. No, sir. Call cops anyway. The two black dudes went, oh, hell no. No, sir.
No, sir.
Oh, man. Oh, I'm hurting. Oh, that was something. Man, oh, hell no. Call the police to my house? All right, top six answers on the board. If they sold a Steve Harvey costume for Halloween, what might it come with?
Mustache.
Come on, pimp. Hey, Robert, what do you do, man?
I have the pleasure of helping students find their purpose. I'm a manager for an enrollment and admissions team over at Grand Canyon University.
Oh, that's good, man. That's good. I like that. Helping young people.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
That's good. I like that. If they sold a Steve Harvey costume for Halloween, what might it come with?
I got to give me one of them nice suits, Steve.
Get that suit on, man. If they sold a Steve Harvey costume for Halloween, what might come with it?
A good joke.
A good joke. Come with a good joke. If they sold a Steve Harvey costume for Halloween, what might it come with?
How about big lips?
Hey, don't take all that. All that in the background. He sure got some biggers. Come with big lips. Come on, Jamie. If they sold a Steve Harvey costume for Halloween, what might it come with?
A bald cap.
A bald cap. Family Feud sucks. Well, all right, Lil Wayne. Ain't no strikes, so you one answer left, you can clear the board. If they sold a Steve Harvey costume for Halloween, what might it come with?
A big nose.
If big nose is up there, I'm gonna tear the game board down. We going home. The game over. I'm gonna tell you right now, if big ass nose is up here, I'm tearing this damn game board up. I tell you what, it better not be up there. If it's up there, I'm gonna tear the damn game board down. I tell you what. Be up here. I'm gonna tear this whole damn game board down. Go ahead. Big ass nose, be up there. All right, Robert, only one strike, one answer left, you can clear the board. If they sold a Steve Harvey costume for Halloween, what might it come with?
You do a lot of talk shows, so what about a microphone?
Microphone. Top seven answers on the board. Name a part of Steve Harvey's body that you bet is as soft as a baby's behind.
That mustache.
I'm gonna tell you right now, if your baby behind feel like this mustache, you need to take your baby to the hospital. Your baby got a problem. Mustache.
Your bald head.
My bald head. I know it's one of y'all up top in charge that flips the board over. You're gonna pay for the little milk dud comment, partner. Oh, it ain't over, homie, okay? Just know that. Stefan, name a part of Steve Harvey's body you bet is as soft as a baby's behind.
You're behind.
Once again, if your baby butt feel like my butt, get your baby to the hospital. My butt. Erica, name a part of Steve Harvey's body you bet as soft as a baby's behind.
I'm gonna have to go with your legs.
Legs. Legs. Vanessa, name a part of Steve Harvey's body you bet as soft as a baby's behind.
I'm gonna say your face.
Face. Londell, part of Steve Harvey's body you bet is as soft as a baby's behind.
I would say nose.
No. Ariel, name a part of Steve Harvey's body you bet is as soft as a baby's behind.
I'm gonna go with your stomach.
Yeah.
You got a smooth stomach.
My stomach.
Your stomach. You got a smooth stomach.
Stomach. Yeah.
Washboard.
Yeah. Washboard.
I got washboard abs. Oh, they in there. You got to dig for them. There go one. That dig round for it. Stefan, name a part of Steve Harvey's body you bet is as soft as a baby's behind.
I'm gonna go with your arms.
Yeah.
Arms, Steve.
Arms. All right, we got two strikes now. Witowski family can steal.
Okay.
Name a part of Steve Harvey's body you bet is as soft as a baby's behind.
I'm gonna have to go with your lips.
Yes!
I'm just saying, Steve!
Watch yourself, little girl. Yeah. That's a true statement. Yeah. Soft and the same size of a baby's ass, too. Lips. A little board operator, you just having a field day. Bee stung lips. I know they big, you ain't gotta say that. Two strikes though, Witowski family can steal. Part of Steve Harvey's body, you bet, is as soft as a baby's behind.
Well, Steve, since I shook your hand, I'm gonna say your hands.
Yeah! Let me tell you something. Name someone Minnie Mouse might call if she found out Mickey Mouse cheated on her.
Bugs Bunny.
Bugs. Bugs.
It's up there,
Jay. No, it's not.
It's up there, man.
Bugs Bunny. Bugs Bunny.
Donald Duck.
Donald Duck. Come on, pass it to me. Boy, somebody Minnie Mouse might call. She found out Mickey cheated on her.
I know she's telling her girl Daisy about it.
Yeah.
Her girl Daisy. Katie, somebody Minnie Mouse might call. She found out Mickey cheated on her.
Goofy.
Goofy.
Oh, Terry,
name someone that Minnie Mouse might call. She found out Mickey cheated on her.
Mortimer Mouse.
Mortimer Mouse. Oh, well. Oh, yeah. That's it. Only got one strike. Name someone that Minnie Mouse might call if she found out Mickey cheated on her.
Loretta Cow?
Loretta the Cow. Hey, Tim.
He's afraid to look.
If Minnie Mouse found out that Mickey was cheating on her, you tell me who you think she called. Just go ahead. Say it, Tim. Just
say it. Mighty Mouse?
Yes.
Yeah! You know who that is.
I know him.
Yes.
Mighty Mouse?
Yes.
Name someone Minnie Mouse might call if she found out Mickey cheated on her.
Steve, we're gonna go with Cinderella.
Yeah.
I tell you what, if that's
on the board, I'm going home. It's Cinderella. If it's up, I swear I'm going home. Cinderella. Number five. Oh, they mad now. That ain't no damn character. You're right about that, bro. Number four. Point values are double. Top six answers on the board. We asked 100 married men, if you were blindfolded, you could still identify your wife by feeling her what?
Her butt.
Her butt, yeah. Her breasts. Corinne, okay, all right, guys, we asked 100 married men, okay? Just say that one time. Corinne, if you were blindfolded, you could still identify your wife by feeling her what?
Them lips, Steve.
Ooh. Feeling her lips. Talk to her. If you were blindfolded, this your wife right here.
Yes, sir.
Now, we got the bosom up there, we got the hiney up there, we got the face, everything on the face. So now, you were blindfolded. You could still identify her by feeling her what?
Her feet.
Good answer.
Her feet. So All right, Cal, you can clap all you want. Ain't got no strikes. You next. If you were blindfolded, you could still identify your wife by feeling her what?
This hair, Steve.
This hair. Cal, there's one answer left. Ain't nobody, ain't no strikes on that board either. Ain't nobody in here but me and you. Now, if you were blindfolded, you could still identify your wife by feeling her what?
Well, you know, Steve, I gotta be respectful of my father-in-law who's in the crowd tonight, but I'm gonna have to go with her lady part, Steve.
Now, if you were blindfolded, you could still identify your wife by feeling her what?
I'm gonna go with her hand.
Good answer.
Her hand. Top six answers on the board. Here we go. Name something of yours you'd never want to see someone stick their fingers in.
Pants.
Huh?
My pants.
In your pants. In your pants.
My nose.
Your nose. Pass the point.
We're gonna play, Steve.
Yeah. Miss Shelley?
Yes.
Name something of yours you'd never want to see someone stick their fingers in.
Well, I'm gonna have to say my booty.
Your answer, and it's up there. It's up there, Steve. It's up there.
In your booty. Shayla, I'm uncomfortable now. Shayla, name something of yours you'd never want to see someone stick their fingers in. Just Jesus.
I'm gonna say my mouth.
Your mouth. Kristen, name something of yours you'd never want to see someone stick their fingers in.
Steve, I don't want anybody to stick their fingers in my food.
Oh, yeah. In my food, yeah. Hey, Miss Barbara. I'm about to just apologize to you right now. I'm just reading what's on the card. Matter of fact, could you read that for me, please? Just read it yourself.
Out loud?
Yes, out loud.
Name please. Something of yours you'd never want to see someone stick their fingers in.
Okay, thank you. Could you answer that right into there, please?
Eyes.
In your eyes.
Name something of yours you'd never want to see someone stick their fingers in.
Thank you.
Ooh, this is a toughie. I'm going to say my wallet.
My wallet. Miss Shelley.
Okay. Well, name something of yours you'd never want to see someone stick their fingers in. I'm gonna say my private parts.
The private parts.
Oh!
Shayla, now anything you say is safe. Name something of yours you'd never want to see someone stick their fingers in. Got
all right, let's hope it's up there. My belly button.
Good answer, Shayla. Good answer, Shayla.
Belly button. I'm doing it all different ways. Name something of yours you'd never want to see someone stick their fingers in.
Your ears.
Your ears. Ladies, top 8 answers on the board. Here we go. Name an animal that women actually like being compared to.
Cat.
Cat. Woo! Pass the point.
We're playing, Steve.
Sanam, name an animal that women actually like being compared to.
Dog. A dog.
A dog. Dog. Neil, just whatever you want to say now. It's wide open now. You couldn't have told me a dog was going to be up there. No. Name an animal women actually like being compared to.
I'll say a lion.
Oh, yeah, it's up there, so yeah. Oh, yeah. Lion. Name an animal that women actually like being compared to.
A sparrow?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Hey. Why not? Dog is on the damn board. I'm done. Sparrow. I'm telling y'all, once dog is up there, hey, man, Arun, name an animal that women actually like being compared to.
I'm gonna go with fish, Steve. like a little mermaid.
Fish! All right, we only got one strike, Nisha. Name an animal that women actually like being compared to.
I'm gonna go with bunny.
A bunny. A bunny. That's a great answer.
Thank you.
Because dog is up there. 2 strikes, you gotta be careful. Sawney family can steal. Name an animal that women actually like being compared to.
A horse.
Horse.
Steve, we're gonna say fox.
Fox. Number 8. 5.
Cheetah.
2.
Cougar.
Top 7 answers on the board. Here we go. Name something a man might say his ex-wife and an elephant have in common.
They're stubborn.
Stubborn.
Body shape.
Body shape. Let's go, Jason. Oh, man. That's my little dude right there. Henry named something a man might say his ex-wife and an elephant have in common.
They're both pretty loud. Good answer. Ooh,
they're both loud. Loud.
Trey, something a man might say his ex-wife and elephant got in common.
They got some big old ears, Steve.
Big old ears. Hey! Mom, name something a man might say his ex-wife and elephant have in common.
They got the same appetite, Steve. She likes to eat.
Big girl gotta eat.
She likes to eat.
Big girl gotta eat. Dave, name something a man might say his ex-wife and an elephant have in common.
I'm gonna say, Steve, some big old feet.
Some big feet.
My big feet.
Yeah! Jason? All right, man.
I don't know about this one.
Yeah, I know. Straight out of high school, you gotta dig deep. How old are you, Jason?
I'm 14. I'm about to turn 15 in about 4 days, I don't know.
Yeah, that's what you always say. You know, whenever you ain't 18, you give your age and the next one up. Yeah. I'm 14, about to be 15. I'm 16 on the way. I'm 16 and 3/4. Yeah. All right, name something a man might say his ex-wife and elephant have in common.
They take big deuces.
Take big old bumps. That's all I got.
They take big deuces. Henry got 2 strikes. Anthony family could still name something a man might say his ex-wife and elephant have in common.
They both got a big old nose.
They both got a big old nose. Trey, 2 strikes. Other family could steal. Something a man might say his ex-wife and elephant have in common.
I don't know if it's true, but they probably both smell. Oh. They got nasty smell.
They both smell. Wow, man. Oh. All right, let's name something a man might say his ex-wife and an elephant have in common.
Steve, we're gonna say she had really rough skin.
She has rough skin. Number 2.
Good memory.
I gotta start coming to rehearsal. Yeah. Top 6 answers on the board. Steve Harvey just knocked on your front door. What do you hope he wants?
Me.
They said, what do you mean by that?
Knocking to come see me as a person. Knocking to come see me, visit me. Pay me a visit.
Come see me.
Steve, I'm gonna say be put on the show.
To put you on the show.
I'm gonna play Steve.
Let's go.
Zach, nice to meet you.
Zach, I like that tie, man.
Thank you.
What do you do, Zach?
So I'm a 29-year-old attorney who works in public policy in Boston.
Zach, you got a couple fans out here, man.
Oh, thank you.
They said, is he single? He said, yeah. They went, hey, Zach. All right, Zach, so you stay by yourself?
No, I'm actually dating.
You know, this story's going the other way, Zach. All right, Zach, so a nice lady?
It's actually a him.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's cool, too. Yeah. Walked into that one. Yeah, just give me a hug, man. Come on, Zach.
Thank you, Zach.
Thank you, Zach. Oh, goodness. All right, well, let's go. Let's meet everybody. So, introduce everybody.
Let me introduce my big fat Greek family to you. I have my sister from the same mister, Chloe. I have my spicy cousin, Julia. Hi. My Thea Kula, so Thea means aunt in Greek, Angela. And my brother-in-law, Tofi.
Yay!
Chloe?
Hello.
I just walked up, knocked on your front door. What do you hope I want?
My number.
Right. Yeah, the old Steve Harvey is back. Hope he wants my number. Julia, I just knocked on your front door. What do you hope I want?
Alcohol.
Your mama and I'm gonna take you out of that school. You keep on. Want some alcohol? Angela, I just knocked on your front door. What do you hope I want?
I hope that you are there to offer me a job, Steve.
Offer you a job. Toffee, we got two strikes. We gotta be careful, buddy. The Allen family can steal. I just walked up to your front door. What do you hope I want?
You're gonna give me money.
Give me some money. All right, Zach, we got two strikes, buddy. We gotta be careful. The Allen family can steal. I just walked up, knocked on your front door. What do you hope I want?
You're gonna send me on vacation, Steve.
I'm sending you on vacation. Just knocked on your front door. What do you hope he wants?
Giving me a new car, Steve.
Gonna give you a new car. Number six. Three. Top six answers on the board. Here we go. We asked 100 women, name a kind of glass you can fit one of your breasts into.
Cup.
A cup.
A wine glass.
Pass the play.
We're going to play.
Let's go. All right, Reggie. Talk to 100 women. Name a kind of glass you can fit one of your breasts into.
Like the punch bowl, the glass.
Damn.
Punch bowl. It depends on the size.
Come on, man. Yeah. Yeah. Love you. The damn punch bowl. Yeah. The punch bowl. Reggie, we asked 100 women, name a kind of glass you could fit one of your breasts into.
A martini glass.
A martini glass. I'd only one strike, Ken. This gonna be good. See, y'all got a lot of education over here. Ken, hang in there, man. We ask 100 women, name a kind of glass you could fit one of your breasts into.
A tumbler.
A tumbler?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. A tumbler! All right, Willie.
All right.
This is where we're gonna find out a lot about you, Willie, because you're a really educated man, nuclear physics. Yeah. This ain't really down your alley at all. So This is gonna be a really good answer. 100 women, name a kind of glass you can fit one of your breasts into.
Shot glass.
Oh, that's so good. A shot glass. Woo! Yeah. Kathy, 100 women, two strikes. Be careful, Schmidt family can still name a kind of glass you can fit one of your breasts into.
A flower vase. A vase. A vase.
A vase. We ask 100 women, name a kind of glass you can fit one of your breasts into.
We're a beer drinking family, so a beer glass, beer mug.
A beer mug. Yeah. Number 6. Gentlemen, top 8 answers on the board. A woman might put in her dating ad, I only want to date men who have what?
A job.
A job. Good.
Money.
Money. 10.3 million. All right, pass and play.
Play.
We're gonna play, Steve.
Let's play. Greg, what do you do for a living, man?
Man, I'm a teacher coach in Hammond, Louisiana, and I have a wonderful wife, Macy, I've been married to for 2 years. And, but my, you know, proudest moment is that we're, you know, I'm a cat dad, proud father of a cat, a wonderful cat named Lucy. She's beautiful, gorgeous, fluffy. Everything about her is wonderful, Steve.
That's my grandchild, yeah.
Now, Mary Beth, you said that the cat is your grandchild.
It's my grandchild. He told me that's all I'm getting, so I just worship her and take pictures and talk to her.
You're highly disappointed in that.
No, Steve,
never,
no.
Never.
Not at all.
I'm very,
she has a dog, too. I have little baby.
I have a dog. Grand dog and another grand dog. They said that's all I get, so.
Of course, she never brings up grandbabies.
So this is your mother.
Yes.
Your mother, your mother.
Uh-huh.
Your mother.
Uh-huh.
And none of you want kids?
Not yet.
I do, but I'm waiting for the perfect man.
Waiting on the perfect man.
Perfect man, they all married. I'm still looking.
No, well, the perfect man is coming back and we know not when.
Okay, you're right, you're right.
You might want to just look into one of these dudes down here on Earth. All right, let's go. A woman might put in her dating ad, I only want to date men who have what?
Hair. Sorry, son.
That's why you ain't got no grandkids like that. You know, it's a little mean stuff like that, Mary Beth. You know, God don't like ugly Mary Beth. Now, it's going to be another 3 years before you have them grandkids. 3 more years. Just said, oh, the dating man got some hair. Now, dating man got some hair. Yeah, well, look at number one, son. Hey, Marianne.
Hey.
Good, good. A woman might put in her dating ad, I only want to date men who have what?
Muscles.
Muscles. Woo! Hey, hey, woo! Well, well, well. Looking for Mr. Perfect. Hey, Alexandra. A woman might put in her dating ad, I only want to date men who have what?
A nice butt.
A nice butt. Kevin, how you doing, sir?
I'm doing good.
All right, buddy, a woman might put in a dating ad, I only want to date men who have what?
A man that was mature.
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 All right, Greg, we got to slow down. We got two strikes now. We got to pull something out. Broadest family can steal. Woman might put in a date, man. I only want to date men who have what?
A car, Steve.
I only want to date men who's got a car. Yeah. Yeah. Oh. All right, family, here we go. Here's your chance. A woman might put in her dating ad, I only want to date men who have what?
I was going to say a house, Steve.
This is a house. Number 7.
Integrity.
6. See, I got all that.
No, you do, you do.
All that. I just ain't got no damn hair. That's all I'm missing is some damn hair. Number 4, let's see if I got this.
Brains. Yeah.
Number 3. All right, ladies, top 5 answers on the board. Here we go. We asked 100 women. You love your fiancé, but hate the ring. What do you do?
Give it back.
Give it back.
Hey. Have them fix it. Have them change it.
Have them fix it. Pass the play.
We're gonna play. Okay.
Brian, we talked to 100 women, buddy. You love your fiance, but hate the ring. What you do?
Steve, I'm gonna say that you tell him no.
Good answer.
You tell him no. I don't like this question, man. Are you serious? A guy, you love him, but you hate the ring. You dump him. Karen, talk to 100 women. You love your fiance, but you hate the ring. What do?
Tell him you hate it.
Tell him you hate it. Hey, Erica, we asked 100 women, you love your fiance, but you hate the ring. What do?
You keep it because you love him.
You keep it because you love him. Thank you to the 40 decent women out there. You hang in there, fellas. All right, here we go. Talk to 100 women. You love your are you married?
I'm not.
Oh, this is gonna be perfect. You've met this man. He's your fiance. You absolutely adore him. He's a wonderful man. He gives you a ring. You hate the ring. Jenna, what do?
Well, Steve, I think I would just tell my friend and not say anything to him.
Tell your friends and not say anything to him. Tell your friends and don't say nothing to him. Only one strike, Savannah. Okay. You love your fiance, but you hate the ring. What do?
I just don't wear it. I don't wear the ring. Yeah.
Don't wear it. One answer left, two strikes, all family can steal. 100 women, you love your fiance, but you hate the ring. What do?
You pretend that you lost it.
You pretend that you lost it. Ladies, okay, shoe world. Take a picture of nice shoes, everybody.
Thank you.
Here we go. Point values are double. Top 7 answers on the board. Name a star who's known for his gorgeous face and bulging biceps.
I'm Tom Cruise.
Tom Cruise.
Good answer.
Channing Tatum.
Channing Tatum. Timothy Jr.
I'm gonna go with The Rock.
The Rock.
Good answer. Okay. Good play, Steve.
All right, let's go. Charmaine, name a star who's known for his gorgeous face and bulging biceps.
I'm gonna go off the edge, Mike Tyson.
Oh, that was funny. Kishan, name a star who's known for his gorgeous face and bulging biceps.
Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Yes. Good answer. Good answer.
Arnold Schwarzenegger. Pastor, name a star who's known for his gorgeous face and bulging biceps.
It's real crazy, but it used to be. I'm sorry to say this, O.J. Simpson. I said used to be. I warned you.
The worst answer. O.J. Simpson. O.J. Simpson. Come on, Tacoa. Name a star who's known for his gorgeous face and bulging biceps.
Steve, I'm gonna say Will Smith.
Will Smith. Now, we got four women over here. There is no way you don't know this answer. Name a star who's known for his gorgeous face and bulging biceps.
We're gonna go with Vin Diesel. Yes.
Vin Diesel! Number seven.
Jason Momoa.
Number six.
Gorgeous face.
Five. Four.
Sylvester
Stallone.
Three.
Top eight answers on the board, ladies. Here we go. Name something women do in a sexy way that most men do not.
Dance.
Dance. That's a good answer.
Strip.
Yeah. Strip.
We're gonna play Steve.
Yeah, I don't know what's going on, but I want to play. I don't know what y'all doing over here, but just as a man walking over here, pick me. I don't know what's going on. All I know is some feathers involved, and they don't look like they hurt. Whip me. All right, family. Deshaun, name something women do in a sexy way most men do not.
Bat their eyes.
Bat their eyes. Deshaun, give me an example of that. How would it be?
Like,
girl, yes. Yes, Lord. You want a car? I'm sorry. I fell for it. Bat your eyes. Danya?
Yes, Steve?
Name something women do in a sexy way most men do not.
Walk.
Girl?
Yes.
Girl. Yes. Let me see it. Come on over here, Donya. Let me see it. Yeah. You better walk, Donya. You better pop. Let them have it. Walk. Name something women do in a sexy way that most men do not.
Lick their lips.
Ooh. Ooh. Yes.
Good answer.
Let's see it, Denise. Come on. Come on, girl, don't be shame. Let me see it. Girl, you want a house? What kind of house you want? Lick your lips. Donnell, name something women do in a sexy way that most men do not.
I'm gonna say, talk, Steve.
Yes. Yes, good answer.
Way they talk. Dominique.
Yes.
Name something women do in a sexy way that most men do not.
When I'm thinking about it, I think about how I shower.
Oh. Well, let's see that. Hello. Hello. Hey! Yeah! All right now. That might not be up there, but damn it, ding! Shower! Sean?
Yes?
Name something women do in a sexy way that most men do not.
Work out.
Work out. Don, you got to be careful. We got two strikes. Titus family can steal.
I'm going to go with sleep, Steve.
Good answer.
Sleep. Name something women do in a sexy way that most men do not.
Flip their hair.
Flip that? Oh. You know what?
Good answer.
I ain't even have to ask Tiffany. Here it is. Flip your hair. Number three. Point values are double. Top eight answers on the board. Here we go. Name something a husband might get his wife for her birthday that would be grounds for divorce.
A sex picture.
Another woman.
Well, Reverend. You didn't know no flower names for strippers, but you done drug another woman into the equation. Another woman.
Yeah.
Oh, Pastor made a comeback. So let's name something a husband might get his wife for a birthday. Be grounds for a divorce.
How about divorce papers?
Divorce papers.
Good answer.
All right.
Name something a husband might get his wife for her birthday that would be grounds for divorce?
Nothing.
Been out there in that garage with your daddy, ain't you? Your daddy messed up one year, didn't get her nothing. Dad, why are you in the garage? Shut up, I didn't get your mom anything for birthday. Nothing. Lisa, name something a husband might get his wife for a birthday that would be grounds for divorce.
I would say, like, a diet. Or, like, you know, tell her to a diet book. Or
a diet book. Hold on. Name something a husband might get his wife for her birthday that would be grounds for divorce.
Some sort of sex toys. Because then it spice it up.
Get some sex toys. Dylan, come on, man. Name something a husband might get his wife for a birthday be grounds for divorce.
Something for himself, Steve. A vacation for himself, time away.
Good.
A vacation for himself. Celeste, two strikes. Allen family can steal. Name something a husband might get his wife for a birthday be grounds for divorce.
How about a gym membership?
Ooh, good answer. Good answer. Good answer. Good answer. A gym membership. Seth, I doubted you, man, but I got to put some faith in you. You spent a lot of time talking to your dad. Let's go. Some of my husband might get his wife for a birthday that would be grounds for divorce.
A new cookbook. He doesn't like her food.
Yeah, good answer.
A new cookbook. Hey, that was a good answer.
STD. STD.
Name something a husband might get his wife for a birthday be grounds for divorce.
An STD, Steve.
Good answer.
An STD. Number eight.
School.
Seven.
Faceless surgery.
Number one.
Vacuum.
Top eight answers on the board. We asked 100 women. Imagine Steve Harvey is single. Tell me why he should take you on a date.
I'm hot.
He's hot.
I would show you a good time.
Yeah. And you win. Huh? What does she mean? They want to know what you mean by that.
Make love.
Come on, church girl. You better praise him. Do it to me.
Wait, 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 wait.
right, let's pass the play.
I think we're gonna play.
All right. All right, we ask 100 women, imagine Steve Harvey single. Tell me why he should take you on a date.
Because I'm educated. Good answer.
Good answer. Good answer. Good answer.
I don't care. What did you say? I don't care.
Let's go.
Let's
go.
If you got less education than me, you're in a world of trouble anyway. Because she's educated. All right, we ask 100 women, imagine Steve Harvey single. Tell me why he should take you on a date.
Because I could cook.
Because she can cook. Alexandra, we ask 100 women, imagine Steve Harvey single. Tell me why he should take you on a date.
I've got lots of money.
You, yeah, girl. You got a lot of money. Talk to 100 women. Imagine Steve Harvey single. Tell me why he should take you on a date.
Because I'm marriage material.
I'm married. You better, girl. You better say it. I'm marriage material. Alex, we ask 100 women. Imagine they were, that Steve Harvey was single. Tell me why they would have me take him on a date.
I'm his number one fan.
I'm his number one fan. Yeah. Only one strike, Francine. Talk to 100. Imagine Steve Harvey single. Tell me why he should take you on a date.
Because I'm a virgin.
Oh, she's a virgin. You got two strikes. You got to be careful. Opal family can steal, Christina. Imagine Steve Harvey single. Tell me why he should take you on a date.
Because I can dance.
Because you can dance. We ask 100 women, imagine Steve Harvey single. Tell me why he should take you on a date.
Because I dress nice and sexy.
Because I dress nice and sexy. Number 7.
Four. I'm single too.
Number 1. Top 8 answers on the board. Here we go. We asked 100 women, name something you like to imagine Steve Harvey wearing when he's relaxing at home.
Nothing.
Nothing.
Boxers.
Boxers. Pass the play.
We're gonna play, Steve.
A leather thong.
Ouch. Sounds painful.
They ain't got nothing to fit. What you
gonna play, Steve? You're
gonna play.
Yeah.
Go on, Dwayne, this, we asked 100 women. This is for women, so don't worry about it. Name something you like to imagine Steve Harvey wearing when he's relaxing at home.
Steve, I think they would still want to see you in one of your fly suits relaxing.
Well, see. All right, Deanna. We asked 100 women. Name something you like to imagine Steve Harvey wearing when he's relaxing at home.
What about pajamas?
Pajamas. All right, let's go. We asked 100 women, name something you like to imagine Steve Harvey wearing when he's relaxing at home.
His tracksuit.
Yep. My tracksuit. Dominique, talk to 100 women. Name something you like to imagine Steve Harvey wearing when he's relaxing at home.
Just his tie.
All right now, Dominique, careful. Yeah. I got a town at the house, you know. I'm gonna tell you right now, there ain't nothing but a situation. Just a tie. All right, Trish Ann, we got two strikes. Gotta be careful, Conti family can steal.
All right, I'm gonna go with some jeans, Steve.
Some jeans.
Good answer.
Woo! We asked 100 women, name something you like to imagine Steve Harvey wearing when he's relaxing at home.
We're gonna say robe.
Robe. Number 8. What? 7.
Sunglasses.
5.
Just a t-shirt.
Just a t-shirt? No damn drawers on? Number 4.
Shorts.
Top 6 answers on the board. Name a comedian who isn't just funny, he's also a stud.
Steve Harvey.
Please, Jesus.
I got you.
Please, Lord. Just anywhere on the board.
You got this.
You better, man. If I ain't in the top 6, I'm gonna be so hurt. Steve Harvey.
We're gonna play.
We're gonna play, thank you. Name a comedian who isn't just funny, he's also a stud.
I'm gonna have to go with Kevin Hart.
Oh, yeah, Kevin Hart. Leah, name a comedian who isn't just funny, he's also a stud.
Said the Entertainer.
Said the Entertainer. Man, Said the Entertainer, my dude. Valerie, name a comedian who isn't just funny, he's also a stud.
I'm gonna have to go with Eddie Murphy.
Eddie Murphy. All right, we got two strikes now. We gotta be careful. The Marr family could steal. Name a comedian who isn't just funny, he's also a stud.
Steve, could I get the meaning of stud?
Can you get the meaning of stud?
Past,
hold
present.
Hold on, wait, let me, hold on. I can do better than that. Ta-da! You know, when they say stud, they mean like, you know, Not necessarily cute or nothing like that. But, you know, got some swag. You know, women, you know, look at him and go, you know, I'm okay. You understand what a story is?
D.L. Hughley. You're D.L. Right?
Name a comedian who isn't just funny, he is also a stud.
We're gonna go with Jimmy Fallon.
That's my man. Woo! Jimmy Fallon. Hey, Jimmy, what can I say? Number six. Another buddy. Number five.
James
My man. Number four.
Dane Cook.
Dane Cook. That's a bad boy. He's funny, man. A man has that his ex-wife hopes gets broken. Jacob. His private parts.
His leg, Steve.
His leg. His leg.
Play.
We're gonna play, Steve.
We're gonna play. Don, name something a man has that his ex-wife hopes gets broken.
His sports car.
His sports car.
Good answer. Yeah. Woo.
Hey, Chad, welcome back, man. Tell me something a man has his ex-wife hopes gets broken.
How about his neck?
His neck.
Good answer.
Hello, young Emily. Give me something a man has that his ex-wife hopes gets broken.
I'm gonna go with his heart.
His heart. That's number one, little Emily. Number one. Nicole, name something a man has that his ex-wife hopes gets broken.
His house.
His house. All right, only one strike, Jacob. Tell me something a man has that his ex-wife hopes gets broken.
I'm gonna go with all of his teeth, Steve.
All of his teeth. Every last one of them.
Every last one of them.
Damn. Well, there goes my career. His teeth. All right, we got two strikes now. We gotta be careful, Dawn. Dowdy family can steal. Something a man has his ex-wife hopes gets broken.
His finances.
His finances. Go broke. Go broke. Chad, name something a man has that his ex-wife hopes gets broken.
His spirit.
Wow. Good answer.
That's very true. Oh, she tried to do that to me. Yeah, that's gotta be up there. Oh, God. Spirit!
Come on, Ed.
Emily, one answer left. You're the young one. You could clear the board, but we got two strikes. The Dowdy family can steal. Name something a man has that his ex-wife hopes gets broken.
His reputation.
Oh, his reputation. Oh. All right, ladies, name something a man has that his ex-wife hopes gets broken.
Steve, we're gonna say his health.
Damn. His health. His health. Number six.